Buckle in. This one is going to be a little crazy, but super important. Block or brick composition, both my own terms, not actual musical terms, just have to deal with the modular aspect of music. This includes themes, motifs, rhythm figures, progressions, blah 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 blah. I like to call it block or brick composition just because as a kid I had an obsession with Lego. To start, let's head on back to the early Renaissance period and listen to the song Lomarmé. Now, this was a crazy popular song back in the day. So popular, in fact, that composers in the early Renaissance started doing covers and remixes of it, but here's how they did it. Let's take that sick melody, and now let's hold it out really long. It's so slow, but it's holding on to the original line, so let's go ahead and call it the tenore. Well, it's all boring now, so what if we put a line on top? Let's fill it out with a lower line, and then maybe one more high line. Now we have this completely different sounding piece, but it's based off of that awesome Lomarmé song. I'm guessing you know where I'm headed with all this. Your music. I'm saying you can use this technique with your music. So let's say this thing is like a little piece of music or whatever. So you got like a melody or something up here, and then some accompaniment, and then like a bass part down here or whatever. So let's say this top part, this yellow part right here. Let's say that is your motif, right? But now you want to use this as a bass line for some other chord progression or whatever. So then, that means you have to make it a little bit longer, right? You have to make it a little longer, and then it has to be on the bottom. So now, you can put something else in the middle to hold it together. Right, because now it's a bass line, so it's a little slower or whatever. You know, you can make it slower, you can make it faster, whatever. And then you throw stuff on top. There you go. So then you have something else. Now everything's repurposed. But then you're like, okay, so maybe I don't really want to do this, but I just want to use a tiny bit for the solo in that other piece. So I have this other piece right here. I'm like, okay, well, I'll just throw a little bit of that onto the solo. So now that's part of the solo that's over here, and it can keep on going, you know, like this. So the whole thing could end up looking something like this if you really wanted it to. So you have the bass line right down here, and you have this going on over here, all the accompaniment, and then you have the melody coming up, and then, oh, look at this, a little bit of the bass line just fell right into the melody. Oh, and then it just goes back. See? Something like that. Let's hear what this might sound like. Here's a melody with some accompaniment. Now I'm expanding the first four notes to make a chord progression for the bass to follow. Let's go ahead and hear what that sounds like. What if we just took the rhythmic motif and used that as a basis for another piece? All I really want you to know is that you can put any part of music anywhere, and though it may not always be what you wanted, that kind of experimentation can really help boost your speed, creativity, and cohesion. All music is made of the same stuff. It's just vibrations. Remember that you can exert your will and control over them.
Thank you so much for watching. If this video was helpful for you, remember to like, share, and subscribe. And please share any of your works. I'd love to hear them. Take care and have fun writing.